A very good afternoon, participants. I welcome all the participants to the seventh day of the online course on human rights education for women. I appreciate the enthusiasm shown by the participants. I can see most of the names becomes familiar to me as every day these participants come every day logging in. And it shows your keen interest on the subject. Today, we have a resource person, Dr. P. Sakthivel, Deputy Controller of Examinations, Annamalai University, Professor, Department of Political Science. A good friend of me, a beloved brother to me. He always plays a motivating, supportive, and influential role in the department in our efforts, endeavor to organize seminars, conferences, and workshops. Sir has completed research projects sponsored by UGC. And more importantly, Sir has this resource person has a reputation of delivering more than 200 lectures across the country on various topics to different kinds of audiences. So this afternoon, his lecture, I'm also eager to listen to his lecture. This afternoon, he is going to talk on human rights violations against women in cyberspace. A very vital, relevant, and most important topic of present day. After globalization, especially after digitalization, when cyber problems started, when cyberspace occupies our day-to-day lives, the cyber crimes, the cyber fraud has become the everyday affair. It is the biggest challenge to find out the culprit, even after finding out the culprit, putting them behind the bars is the biggest challenge. How we can make ourselves safe from this cyber world. Without the cyber world, today we cannot act. Everything we have in the cyber world. Even today we are meeting from different corners of the country only through cyber world. So without which our day-to-day life, development, growth, everything will not be meaningful. So we need cyber world, but how to use the cyber world safely. So all these things are very vital. This resource person has rich experience and exposure to this area of specialization. This resource person has written articles on Tamil, reputed Tamil dailies. So I think this afternoon is going to be a big one for the participants as well as to me. I request the participants to make use of this lecture, and I expect more questions from the participants during the second session. Now I request and invite Dr. Sakthivel sir to deliver his talk. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. V.S. Balamurugan, and for your nice words and introduction about me to the audience. Thanks to the department, HOD Dr. C. Subramanian, faculty members of the Department of Political Science, my own colleagues, especially Dr. S. Balamurugan, other technical team members, Ms. Narmada, PhD scholar, Mr. Sivanesan. So all along with the department for the past 7 days, so they are really working behind the department, conducting the online course. And today, it's my privilege and a proud privilege. I'm going to deliver my lecture on human rights violations against women in cyberspace. So hope that most of the lectures, they focused upon offline world. But now I am going to focus about what we call it as online world, virtual world, or cyberspace, or internet. And now more than 50 days, the nationwide lockdown, and people's movement is essentially minimized. And government and multinational company wanted people to work from home, and there is no other way that we have to work from home through ICT enabled devices such as mobile phone, a laptop, and other electronic gadgets. So when more people log into the website, naturally there is a possibility of more human rights violations against women in cyber world and cyberspace. My dear friends, don't think that I am a male participant, I am a male counterpart. The topic is need not essential for me. Don't think. If you think, your perception is wrong. Here, in your family, maybe your sisters, maybe your mother, maybe your children, if we were kids, both male and female, definitely you need to carry the information, you need to disseminate the information to your family members about safe surfing of internet and how you can protect yourself from the any kinds of rights-based violations in the internet world. And certainly you are going to be listen very interesting information and data, and how the mobile phone itself can be used as a tool to protect yourself. So ICT enabled devices, by using your mobile phone, mobile applications, you can encounter and you can combat any problem. So with this brief introduction, now I'm just going to start my presentation with some of the informations and useful slides are available. As I told, human rights violations against women is very pertinent, not only in your family or outside the family in society, but even in the internet world, cyberspace, there is more violations are taking place. If you see, my dear friends, conventionally, the violence against women are, one is physical violence, mental stress for the women, discrimination in financial life. Even in the year of 21st century, women's economic rights are being discriminated in the financial life, especially in private company, multinational company. The Google is not exception case. Our topmost multinational companies are not exception in this case. There is a equal pay for equal work. The principle is not applicable, and they are not following also. You know, in Western country, the people filed a case against the topmost leading IT companies. Then you come to another is a dowry harassment, honor killing, and throwing acid in the faces of the women and children. It's very pertinent. And coming to the seventh one is a sexual violence against women. So these are all conventional rights-based violations against women. But when come to the last one, which I'm going to focus, that is online or cyberspace rights violations. So this is the entire, some 40-45 minutes I'm going to share my experience. And I should say that it's my rich experience. For the last few years, I have been working on that particular line. I have a lot of data to show you. Okay. Let us first understand the concept of cyber world or cyberspace. Cyber world or cyberspace is nothing but it is an internet world. So if you are talking with your friends in the family, it is an offline world. But when you are connected with the internet, when you are surfing in the internet, there you meet your friends, there you are exchanging your information, so photos and videos, and kind of chatting is going on between you and your friends in the cyber. It is called a cyberspace. Cyber world is nothing but, my dear friends, it is an environment where the more participants are involved in social interaction. For example, the Zoom app, right now we are conducting the program. This itself is a cyber world. It is an online environment. Whether it is a Facebook, Twitter, Link India, Google Talk or a lot of mobile apps and internet apps are available. So when people interact in cyberspace through digital media, then it is called a cyber world. See the photo in India. When 10 Indians, they log into the internet, especially the women, 8 out of 10 Indians, they faced online harassment. So nobody's exception. Whether the women in the age group of 18 to 20 or in the age group of 30 to 35 or even above age 45, everybody is a victim of human rights violations in the cyberspace. This is the very, very recent data which I wanted to show you. In Delhi, in Instagram, some college, not college, school students, they created a blog, they created a WhatsApp group or chat group called Boys Locker Room. And they admitted some 15-20 students in the group. And naturally, the admin started to share some of the photos by doing a morphing, by altering the photos downloaded from the WhatsApp profile or downloaded from the Facebook or any other medium. And they shared the photos in the group. And finally, the cybercrime police, especially in New Delhi, they come to know that there are something is going on unusually in Instagram. And the admin of the group was arrested, and he is a college, not a school student. So when more people they entered into the Instagram or LinkedIn or Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, WeChat, or any medium that is online world, there is a more possibility of human rights violations or rights-based violations. So this is the photo, the data which I have taken the last month, April 14, in the newspaper Hindu. Online child phone traffic is increased by 95%. You know, when more people they sit in the home, when more people compelled to work in the internet, naturally they enter the website and they search something. Sometimes, and most of the time, we are fruitfully we are searching some information document. But some criminals, I use the words criminals, and some unidentified persons, they use the internet as a tool to download some unwanted photos, videos from the internet. Now the cybercrime, especially in Chennai, they are following accounts of more than 3,000 people. Those who are downloading these unwanted videos or child sex videos, child porn from the website, and they are following the people, and sometimes they booked a case against these people also. So what I'm trying to say, when more people went to the website, and when they log into the website, one is women and second is children. They are more prone for rights-based violations in the internet. So this is coming to Kozhikode. No? This is another classical example where the police, they arrested a person by using Instagram, and he downloaded the photos of the girls from various parts of the Kozhikode district and circulated the photos with the friends. No? And finally, the youth were arrested under IT Act. I'm going to explain what is the IT Act 2008, how the women can use IT Act 2008, and how they can rescue themselves, or how they can get reprieve from the existing law. I will explain later. So the police arrested the person within 3 days. And these criminals, normally they use a fake account, and you are not able to very easily, you cannot chase the people also. So when you are using Instagram or WhatsApp or Facebook, especially the children and the women, be careful and be sure that you are sharing the information with your friends only. And coming to another is cyber crimes against women. Every second, one woman in India, they are the victim of cyber crimes. That is what the data shows. And coming to another is, in 100%, 66% of the cyber crimes are committed against women by the youth, especially in Maharashtra. So the youth, the age group 15 to 20, 15 to 30 years, they are the people more prone to access to internet, and they violate the rights of the women, children in the online world. Then coming to, you know, there is a lot of social media platforms are available, Twitter, Facebook, Google Plus, Reddit, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube. There is a lot of mediums are available. But you should be very careful. Especially you should teach the lesson to your family members, especially the women and children, that if you are logging to the website, be careful. See that you are sharing only the very useful informations. Don't think that it is only Shakti Vel and the participants of the course we are discussing the issue. You know, the United Nations organization, they appointed a commission that is called the UN Broadband Commission, and the commission has submitted a report to the UN that the cyber crimes or the criminals, they use ICT devices such as the internet, the mobile phones, other online sources in order to subvert or suppress the women and abuse the women in cyberspace. Now, cyber crimes including hate speeches in the internet, using unparliamentary words, derogatory statements in the online, it is a hate speech. Hacking, that is without your knowledge, your mobile, your email and your internet password, everything is hacked by the hackers. And there is identity theft is also taking place in internet. And online stalking is nothing but when a woman is entered in the web, that is the internet, then people are immediately following the woman in the internet. When she moves from internet to WhatsApp, then the woman is being followed by the people in the WhatsApp. When from WhatsApp she went to the Facebook, there the woman is also being closely monitored, watched by some ex or wife. This is what we call it as online stalking. So there is online threats and induced suicides. These kinds of violations are taking place against women. This is what the UN says it is a cyber crime scenario. Now the internet also facilitates other forms of violation against women, such as women trafficking and abusing the women and sexually abusing the women in internet. Just to see the PowerPoint, the reasons for or the motive for cyberspace rights violations, one is a personal revenge. See, when I was a student, any problem if I encountered with my friends, I will talk to my friends one-to-one. But now the people are not ready to talk to one-to-one in offline, that is in the street. Immediately they go to the website and they follow the X or Y's ID, identity. And naturally there is a personal revenge. And for settling scores, emotional, anger, revenge, the people are using cybercrime. And coming to the greed, wanted to have more money, wanted to have a lust for power or lust for sex, and there is a more cyber crimes are taking place for financial benefits, financial gain. The cyber crimes are taking against women. Then last one is illegal gain and insult to the women in the internet. Then there is cyber crimes are taking place. Then coming to, don't think that, my dear friends, it is only taking place in India, but even if you go Brazil or even go to the Thailand, I am just showing the research one conducted by ActionAid Research. Whether it is a Brazil or Thailand, the UK, more women, more children are victim of cyberspace rights violations. Then you come to India. One social organization, they conducted a study that 82% of the women, they said that they have encountered and they have faced some problem in the internet. And I am happy to share with you, 82% of the women, the victim of cyber crimes, they have taken some steps to protect themselves against harassment. In the last part of my discussions, I am going to tell you how you can protect yourself. Some of the helpline numbers I am going to share with you. Some of the mobile applications also I am going to share with you. And I am requesting the participants, don't scribble on the online, because you cannot, or the people cannot understand the content of the presentation also. Okay, fine. You know, this is the very famous journalist, Barkha Dutton. If you are watching NDTV, that is New Delhi Television, she's very popular in NDTV and she's an anchor, like Dr. Balamurugan, she's an anchor and she's conducting debates in the NDTV. And you know what happened? She was routinely harassed in the Twitter and the Facebook. And what happened finally? She closed her Facebook and a Twitter account, then coming out of the Facebook Twitter account. So there is a complete kind of rights-based violations that take place in internet now. Then coming to, I'm shocking, that's the NCRB, you know, National Crime Records Bureau. You get all the data regarding online world rights violations. There is a NCRB data which is available. You just see a new class of crimes is rapidly increasing due to extensive use of internet and other IT-enabled devices or services. Just listen, my dear friends, a new class of crimes which you cannot understand. The more problem in India, we are not able to distinguish who are good citizens and who are the bad citizens, who are the criminals and who are the defaulters. So what the NCRB data says, there is a new type of crimes, a new types of criminals are emerging in internet. And now there is a wake-up call has been given that the Indians are number two in the world in sharing all the personal information. Please, I request all the participants, don't share your personal information in the internet. Then coming to another, just to show your attention to this Information Act 2008. Initially, there is an act was passed in 2000, the IT Act. Now the government modified the act, updated the Information Technology Act 2008, and it was implemented. Now, these are all the sections are available. When you face any problem in internet or online, you can follow the act and you can file a case. In case of this Kozhikode incident, I told Instagram, the police arrested the person, defaulter. They arrested on the basis of the IT Act 2008. Section 66E deals with identity theft. 66E deals with the violation of privacy and publication and transmission of any absence conduct in the internet is also prohibited as per the IT Act. And another thing is, without the knowledge of the women or the children, when you are sharing information in the internet, you are liable for punishment and you will be punished by the IT Act 2008. So publication of material without the consent of the women or the children or even the boy or the girl, it invites punishment under Section 72 of Information Technology Act. So my dear friends, don't think that the act is only applicable to the women. It is also applicable to the men. If the man is also a victim, the man can also file a case in Section 72 of IT Act. So kindly note down all the information. When you face any problem, encounter any problem, you can easily get the reprieve from the government. Then coming to another latest development is prohibition of or indecent representation of women prohibition act 2013. Now what is the goodness of this act, my dear friends? The act prohibited indecent representation of women not only in the offline world, that is in the public street, in paper, but it extended to the prohibition of audio-visual media and content in electronic form in the internet. So when you're talking about IPC, when you're talking about Indecent Representation of Women Act 1986, it talks about only the offline. But now the recent Act 13, it includes any material if you are posting without the knowledge and without the consent of the women, it is also liable for punishment as per the 2013 Act. So another thing is, there is a Section 354 Class A is available, demanding sexual favors, showing pornography against the will of the women or the children or a boy or the girl. It also invites punishment in Criminal Amendment Act 2013. Then coming to another important section is, disseminating such information without the consent of the boy or the girl is also invites punishment. And more important, my dear friends, see this last one. Section 354D, it deals with cyber stalking following the women in the internet and despite any clear indication or disinterest. So monitoring the cyber activity, there is a Section 354D is included in the Criminal Amendment Act 2013. So who are more prone for the cyber crimes, cyber violations or rights violation? The college students. And the reason for college students, they are not properly sensitized about the evils of cyber world crimes. So it is the purpose of this program that we wanted to sensitize the women, we wanted to disseminate the information. Information should reach the various stakeholders, especially the men, the women, children, and other stakeholders. So my dear friends, be sure that when you are logging to the social media, such as Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, you are chatting with only your friends. Now coming to this is very, very vital. The Supreme Court of India says in the last year, right to privacy. Right to privacy, I quote from the Supreme Court of India judgment. Right to privacy is a protector and it is nothing but it is an integral part of a right to life and personal liberty under Article 21 of Indian Constitution. That is guaranteed in the Part 3 of the Indian Constitution. What is a Part 3? I know morning also, we are conducting one training program on fundamental rights, fundamental duties. There also I have delivered my lecture. Article 21 is a classical article where the Supreme Court of India says it is a heart and soul of the fundamental rights is Article 21. My dear friends, the forthcoming days, the court can include health rights, women's rights, especially in cyberspace rights, privacy, our right to health, right to prosperity, right to sustainable development, everything in Article 21. The scope is enormous in Article 21, that is right to life and personal liberty. So the court says it is a privacy of the individual. Don't think that your privacy is confined with the four walls in your home. I'm sorry. Even if you are coming out of your home, that is your family system, when you are coming to the public, your privacy is being guaranteed. You just see the judgment. I have shown some 10 important points in the judgment. One is privacy is not confined to your bedroom or your washroom, as the court says. Privacy is extended to your bedroom, privacy is extended to your washroom, privacy is extended to your home. And another thing is, if you feel that your rights has been violated in the internet, you can move to the court. You can move to the court as per the important judgment by the Supreme Court of India. And personal information is protected from public scrutiny. What is a public scrutiny? You will not be compelled by any X or Y to furnish all the data, especially your Aadhaar number, your PAN card, and your biometric identification, and or your iris, or any other data. Then coming to another thing is, privacy is nothing but it is an intrinsic part of right to life and personal liberty of Article 21. Sometimes before I told, it is Article 21 which protects your right to privacy also. Then another thing is, central government was asked to put a robust regime for data protection. What is a robust regime for data protection? Now the government should take care of measures to protect the information being given, in whether it is the form of Aadhaar or in the form of any electronic data. When you are submitting, when you submitted with the government and other agencies, it is a duty of the government, they should protect the information you furnished with the government. So some other the data is available, then I will go to the another thing is, so what are the nature and what different kinds of cyberspace rights violations are taking place? One is email harassment. I will tell you, email harassment. You know, my dear friends, we are all in the age group of 40s and 50s. You know, you wanted to harass a woman. In those days, I'm talking about some 20 years or 30 years before, we used to write a letter and we send it to the girl or the boy. Then naturally, there is a harassment is taking place in the paper. But now, what is taking place in nowadays? The email harassment is taking place, and there is a lot of mental stress and agony for the women after reading the email. So the email, which contains derogatory statements, unparliamentary words, or the words which are not been used for official purpose, is being used, and the woman is harassed through email also by using, or the criminals are using, fake email IDs and IP and address also. Now coming to the second is a cyber stalking. I told my dear friends, stalking is a behavior where the individual is purposefully and frequently threaten the women in the internet. So following the women in the street is stalking. But following the women in the cyber world is called cyber stalking. 75% of the cyber stalking victims are women and children. So be careful, my dear children, my dear women, be careful when you are entering into the internet. Coming to another thing is, you know, the motive for cyber stalking. It is a behavior where mostly the women are harassed sexually and lust for love and personal revenge or hate and ego, etc., etc. That is a reason for cyber stalking. Then coming to the third type of human rights violations against women and children is cyber pornography. You know, every day we take a selfie, but I don't take a selfie now. Because I am not, I don't believe in that taking selfie and send it to my friends. And average, the Google says Indians are taking 13 to 14 selfie every day. That's what Google says, I'm not saying. So 14 to 15 selfie we are taking every day, the average, and we are sharing with our friends. In the WhatsApp profile also, we use the selfie photos. So naturally, the criminals, they download your photos from the WhatsApp profile. Today, I'm requesting my dear girls and my dear children, if you are having your photos in the WhatsApp profile, kindly remove it and have any other photos, not your personal photos. And naturally, it invites a lot of chances for doing alteration or doing some pornography And again, the criminals, they post the photos in the internet. The simple example, I'm just going to finish my first session. Simple example is a Kerala experience. So in the Instagram, the criminals download the photos from the Instagram profile only. So be careful, my dear friends, when you are sharing your photos and other personal informations. Now it's Dr. Balamurugan.
Dear participants, as the time is running out, now we are terminating the connection and we will resume back in the next 2 minutes.
So, in the previous session, I just briefed about the child pornography. You know, 95% increase in the internet, especially the child-related sexual abuse and downloading the unwanted photos in the website is increased to the 95%, especially in the lockdown period. Then coming to after cyber pornography, we have another the problem with regard to the cyberspace rights violations is, the next one is, I think some problem in PowerPoint. Cyber defamation. Good. So it happens very frequently in the internet in order to make a character assassination of the women through posting some derogatory statement. Now, I told again, repeatedly, we all belong to the 20th century generation. In those days, when you wanted to make some character assassination or by using some unwanted remarks against women, they use this offline, that is, postal letters or the courier. But now the internet has become very perfect tool for the criminals. They target women, not only women, but they target her friends and relatives also by using unwanted mentioning about the character of the woman, the personality of the woman, and through the online world, they post some unwanted derogatory statement. This is called cyber defamation. Then coming to the another kind, the cyber crime is a morphing. So morphing is nothing but, my dear friends, changing the picture and the image into a completely different one by using computer software. You know, Tamil Nadu people, they aware about Vinupriya and Vishnupriya. The college student was committed suicide because her photo was downloaded from the Facebook and WhatsApp. And by doing morphing, the photo of the girl was modified. And again, it was sent to the women and her relatives. And a lot of mental agony, mental stress for the woman. And finally, she committed suicide. So the victim's picture is downloaded from website, especially WhatsApp, Facebook, etc., etc. Then they modify it with another picture and they place it to her face with another face and they circulate it with the friends. Such unlawful activities will attract punishment under IT Act 2008 and more important is Indian Penal Code Section 509 also. Then coming to cyber spoofing. So spoofing is nothing but, don't think that these are all technical terms. No, it's not a technical term, simple. So without the knowledge of the girl, the criminals or the hackers, they enter into your domain and they steal your data or they spread some malware, that is an infected virus they spread to your mobile or your laptop or the computer, bypassing access control. You know, the Zoom meeting, when we admit, the participants can enter. But in case of internet, even without your knowledge, without your admission, the cyber criminals can enter into your domain, enter into your website, web blog, or your domain. Then naturally, they can steal the data, they can see the data. And don't think that, my dear friends, only ordinary persons are victims. I'm sorry. Not only ordinary person, even the government website, the defense website, or even the IT website are also subject to attack by the cyber criminals. Then coming to another interesting information, and I don't know how many of you are aware about this information, is sex offender registry in India. The central government has launched, I think in 2017-18, the central government has launched a sex offenders registry. That is nothing but a portal is opened in the internet It contains all the information about the criminals, including the name of the criminals, address, professional details, locality, phone number, PAN card, Aadhaar, driving license, educational qualifications, and even more important, the fingerprints of the criminals who are doing criminal activities, hate crime, or violating the rights of women in internet. Then you can see the photo. Then 2008, within few months of launching the sex offenders registry, more than 4.4 lakh entries are available in the sex offenders registry. That was taken in 2018. So in one portal, you can get all the details about the defaulters, his professional qualification, address, other details. Now I am coming to a very interesting part of my discussion. Please listen very seriously, carefully, because there are certain mobile applications are available which you can use it, which you can also spread the information to your friends. That there are apps are available, that is mobile applications are available. In Delhi and Puducherry, the police already developed a special mobile application, what we call it as a MITRA Mitra. Most of the participants, they are aware. In Mitra app, what you have to do is only you can just register your details regarding your address, and there are three important numbers you have to register with this app. And when you are caught by the strangers, or when you are detained by some criminals in the public place, naturally, if there is a provision is available in the app, when you press three times the particular panic button, then the message will go to the police control room and the emergency contact number is available. And the nearest police station, the message will go to the nearest police station. The police will come and they will rescue you. But the only thing is, only 10 to 15 minutes, if you are able to safeguard yourself, and you can be very safe. Now, coming to the railway. So more than that, our family, we are traveling and we are spending more time in the travel. For the travels, especially in the Indian Railway, they launched a Mitra app. It is for the safety and the security of the railway passengers. So when you are traveling in a train, when you face any problem, when you encounter any problem, in that particular app, there is a provision is available called a panic button. What is it? Panic, P-A-N-I-C, panic button is available. If you press three times, the message will go to the railway police, including your compartment and your seat number. The train number details will go to the police control room and they will come and they will rescue. You know, I told that Pondicherry, they launched, New Delhi, they launched, Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, they launched a mobile application for the safety of the women. This is very, very interesting and very useful information to the children and women. There is an All India mobile number is available, 112. And these 112 mobile applications are also available. You just download this 112 mobile application from the Google Play Store. You install, especially the girls and the children, they should install this 112. So this 112 is nothing but it is All India helpline mobile application. If you encounter any problem while working, or even the domestic worker, if you face any problem, there is a provision available in the 112. You can press the panic button, then you will get. Not only the police, not only the government, even the politicians, the cinema personalities, they also develop some mobile applications for the safety of the women. My dear friends, there are 50 or 50 plus apps are available to protect the women in online. Especially you can prevent any kinds of cyberspace rights violations in Tamil Nadu. So this is for the interest of the Tamil Nadu participants. There is an app is available, SOS app, that is emergency app is available, that is called Kavalan mobile applications. So only three steps: download the app in the Google Play Store, register with your number and enable your identity, and give some three numbers. One is your mother or father, or your wife or husband, or your children. Then naturally, if you are having any problem, within 5 to 10 minutes, the police will come and they will rescue. Now the government, the democratically elected government across the world, they are protecting the women, not only in offline, but through online measures, that is ICT-enabled devices, mobile phone, internet, laptop. They protect women through mobile apps also. And in Tamil Nadu, there is a 181. I'm sorry, this is in Tamil. I will just translate in English. This is 181. For example, if you have any sexual harassment in working place, then there is a one free helpline is available, 181. The people can call 181. And naturally, the police will assist you how you can rescue yourself, protect yourself. Then, this is about 112. I told my dear friends that there is a 112 app is available. It was introduced by the Home Minister, Rajnath Singh. It was introduced in 2018. This is an integral. One is for any fire-related, any health-related, safety of the women, everything. They combine together with one number, that is 112. You can make use of this opportunity also. So this is very interesting and a very useful point regarding how cyber safety tips are available, how you can be safe in internet. So what are the tips which I can share with you? So talking only the problem or the issue doesn't fulfill the purpose of the program. I'm just going to share my own experience. Though I am a male counterpart, why I always follow all the instructions. One is, remember that all the internet users are strangers. Don't believe all the internet users and be careful, extremely careful, when you are sharing personal information about yourself. You know, there is one Tamil movie, I think the Tamil people know that, Irumbuthurai. There is one Tamil movie, Irumbuthurai. In that particular movie, I'm just narrating the story. In that particular movie, in Facebook and WhatsApp, we share our children's likes and dislikes. So my children, for example, my children like cake, especially the strawberry cake. So I just share the information in the WhatsApp or the Facebook. Now what happened, the strangers, they get the lead from my postings and my information, and they collect all the data, information about my children, likes and dislikes, and they target my children. This is the entire movie, that is Irumbuthurai. Then coming to next is, be extremely careful about meeting online friends. I'm in person. So when you are having friends in the internet, and when you are going to meet the online friends in the offline, that is a restaurant or in public place, be careful when you are meeting your online friends. Then another important thing is, save all communications. Even if you get any informations or any derogatory statements, save all the communications as evidence. When you wanted to file a case in the cyber crimes, the cyber cell, this will be evidence enough. You keep all the evidences. Be aware about all the emails and SMS. So any SMS, any mail, if you get with a link, even during the COVID pandemic period, people you wanted to donate money to the Prime Minister of India Care Fund or Chief Minister of India, Tamil Nadu Care Fund, then there is a link is given. Don't log into the link and don't share your information also. Even if you are going to the restaurant, you need not share all the data. Don't write your mobile phone, mobile number, your email address, nothing at all. If they wanted to get a feedback from you, say that I don't want to share all the information. Then another thing is, be sure that when you are connecting with Wi-Fi network, see that you have strong password. Then I told my friends always in classroom, don't share your password with anybody. So just a funny way, I'm just telling you, people get ATM card from the bank and they write a PIN number on the backside of the ATM card. Don't do it. That nonsense. So such things will invite a problem for you. No? Change the password frequently, at least once in a month, once in 3 months. Change your password with a very strong password. Create a strong password. Don't use your vehicle number, your first 4 number of your mobile number or your date of birth or X or Y. Have a strong password with a special characters. No? And another thing is, when you are entering or when you are logging to the email, once the communication business is over, you just sign out, then you come out of your email. This is very, very interesting. Watch for HTTPS. When the S is appearing in HTTPS, then if it is a S is available, it is a secured website. If it is a S is not available, be careful in the toolbar or in the address bar. Never post any sensitive information in the social network and the marriage sites. Only limited information you can sign. So last one is, never be greedy for free downloading. When something they given for the free downloading, don't download. That it might infect your computers also. So don't share your personal information, photos, any secret information in the Facebook, WhatsApp, or the Twitter, Link India. This is very, very essential. And last one is, minimize your social media network also. Don't use unnecessarily the social media. And coming to the last slide, I just going to share some of the very, very useful number, especially the girls and women participants. Kindly take a screenshot or kindly note down the numbers. This is very, very valuable numbers. I'm just going from the bottom. That is 112. That is an All India helpline for the women in distress. not only sexual violence, not only problem or human rights violations, but any problem the women they encounter at the All India, this is applicable to Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, or Northeast, North, South, East, West. So people can use them. Any railway-related inquiry or any issues if you are facing in travel, 139 is available. You can use the 139. And for the children and in difficult situation, the children can use 1098. So kindly type all the helplines and give it to your children or visibly you paste in your home also. There is a 181 women helpline for domestic abuse. So any domestic issue, no, now the COVID pandemic period, people are not coming outside the family, but they are working within the family. Then naturally there is a spike in domestic violence against women also. If that is the case, the women can use 181 as a women helpline. Then for the women helpline, 109 for the All India level women helpline, 181 for the Tamil Nadu, whereas 1091 is available for the All India Women Helpline. And the National Commission for Women has developed a WhatsApp group. The number I'm not able to recollect. There is a WhatsApp number is available. Through the WhatsApp also, women can file a complaint. Then coming to the last one is 1090 is available. So for any immediate relief, this is the toll-free number. Don't worry. It is a free that the women can help and the women can seek the help from the police and other counterparts. So the purpose of this training program, that is a rights education for the women, we wanted to create an equal world, that is an enabled world. The equal world is nothing but the women should be respected both in online and offline. So the rights of women should be protected both family as well as in the internet also. Now its future is going to be technocracy. What is a technocracy? It is a technology is going to rule the country, rule your life. So more people, they will spend most of the time with the computer, internet, ICT. Naturally, there will be a spike. There will be a huge spike in online-related rights-based violations. There is a possibility. So please listen the lecture. And whatever you get the information from the lecture, kindly pass on the information to your family members. At least today, you speak to our children, you speak to our women, you speak to our mother, you speak to our, especially the girl children, about safe surfing, safe internet, etc., etc. I thank once again the department, the HOD, other faculty members, and as well as the participants for nice listening of my lecture. Hope that I have done justice and you have also learned something from my presentation also. Thank you. Now it's Dr. Balamurugan, sir.
Thank you.